Hello everyone, Genesis Rider here with another Genesis Tips and Tricks video for you. Today we'll be going over all the non-DLC maps in Team Slayer and giving you some tips and tricks with how to start out on your team with that map off your initial beginning spawn, where you should go, what you should do, where you should set up or attempt to be and to help your teammates. And this was an idea suggested to me over Twitter. Shortly, my face will go away from the corner and you'll be watching my video commentary, but I would like to add that these are just my personal opening strategies. A lot of pro players and even people who are far better than I am have very advanced tactics with their own team, and I try to show a little bit of that in the video, but sometimes I just show you general concepts and ideas that you can expound upon with your own armor abilities or loadouts and just sort of jumpstart you into knowing what you should do off the beginning of a game with your team. That's the general purpose of this video. I hope it adds to your mental arsenal of ideas and ways to play better at Halo 4. Hope you enjoy. Spent a long time making it. And I'll see you guys in the next video. And thanks for watching. Alright, so here we are on the map Opus, and I just want to show you some strategies for starting out on this map. Most new players will spawn right here on this platform and run forward so that they can see the enemy team spawn right here. And this is the wrong way to approach beginning on this map. So let me show you some of my team strategies. You need to send two people through the teleporter to immediately take control of rockets, which are on my HUD. So as a team, two players need to decide, okay, we're gonna sprint forward, turn, immediately go through this teleporter, which will take us up to this teleporter exit door, you can see right here, and immediately sprint around the corner and grab rockets. Now all of this is going to be very quick motion. You're going to be sprinting throughout that entire thing. Immediately when you grab rockets, you want to be watching your radar to make sure that the enemy team hasn't already come to the teleporter as well. If they do, give them a good rocket on their platform. That's where your second teammate can help you if you're contesting rockets, but your other teammates will also be helping you. If you see guys come through here or down here, which is probably, you can now understand why this is a bad reason why you would want to come through the bottom area, you need to rocket them as well. So let's go to what your other two teammates should be doing. So your other two teammates should immediately look right, sprint, grab these two plasma grenades, which are sitting right here, and charge over here. Now this is likely what the enemy may be doing. So one teammate should definitely stay here in this general area behind this pillar to try to avoid getting naded. If they do, they may even have to jump to this rock. The purpose of these two teammates is not necessarily to grab the sniper, although that will be important once your team controls the rockets. But the rockets are the most pivotal point on this map. You need to be looking at teleporter to make sure that you can DR or shoot people coming through teleporter or happening to come around here. And even loading out with a light rifle might be a good idea. Your secondary teammate should engage but not fully commit to players pushing up here. The reason why is because the rocket player top middle should be the priority. He should be able to look at and call out and kill any players over here. So opening strat might be to run forward, you know, toss a grenade to deter, and then look here, track behind this little pillar, while your second teammate maybe pushes up, grabs snipe, and looks here in case there's no one on your radar. Now, all these strategies can change at a moment's notice depending on what's presented to you on your radar, so I'm trying to cover as many tactical angles as possible. Another brief strategy on the map Opus that I'd like to briefly point out, let me just go through this teleport and get to top middle here, is the fact that when you come out of here, your two players come out of here, if an enemy player, let's say an enemy player, you come out here to this window, and you come around this corner only to realize an enemy player is walking right there and is about to get the rockets anyway, okay? Or they're too few steps ahead of you. You don't have to try to bum rush for rockets because all he's gonna do is turn around and then he's gonna rocket himself and you, okay? Killing probably both of you and most likely just you. What you wanna be doing here is you want to be nading where he's going to be and then shooting the heck out of his head. You can bait the power weapon. If players are heading headlong for a power weapon, you need to be grenading where they're going to be. Grenades are critical in any sort of opening strategy, and you'll be seeing that on maps like Haven, which we'll be moving to next. So those are the opening strats for Opus. Alright, so for opening strategies on Haven, they can be applied to both sides as the map is symmetrical. As you can see, a sword spawns top middle concussion rifle and down bottom trophy. And that's upper Mohawk. And then you have the open sniper spawn and open ramp. So how would we go get to the sniper from here? Well, all you have to do is sprint, jump to this little beam, sprint again, and if you have a thruster pack, just thrust over here a little bit more, and you can grab the sniper. Now, something I'd like to point out that a lot of players don't seem to understand is that when you are jumping over, you can provide some damage to top middle, because obviously at least one or two of your teammates, preferably two of them, should be running top middle like this, all right? One should be going to the right, the other should be going to the left. In fact, the person going to the left should be jumping here, and they should be nading right here. Okay, this is because to prevent the enemy from doing this. The reason why you want to jump to here is to get a slight head advantage. This is a really easy way to see them. In fact, this is one of the best vantage point, opening vantage points in the map. This is why you want to nade it and take it away from the enemy team. This is a better nade right here, throwing it a little off this wall so it bounces and fully cascades all over this platform. No need to throw it off the platform itself. Now, when I was talking about the jump over here, what I was mentioning is that while you are jumping, you can jump onto this platform, but while you are jumping over here, you can turn like this, for example. You can turn and throw grenades or shoot. In fact, throwing grenades at that angle is critical, because if you're able to throw a grenade from here, you can imagine you can hit it right here. For your other two teammates, this is nigh impossible because of this big structure in their way. Even if they were to throw a grenade off this angle, it would only hit like right here. So this person's job when they're jumping over for the sniper should be to stay alive right here, let their teammates push up, but also provide critical nades on these areas. As you can tell, this person who is jumping onto this this platform right here should already be nading their platform. So the guy jumping over doesn't have to worry about that. He just needs to worry about putting one or two perfect nades, probably only going to be able to get one perfect nade right into this area. Now the fourth guy, what is he going to be doing? Well, the fourth guy's job, and this is just something that I really like it when my teammates do this, it's to sprint as fast as humanly possible, oftentimes having the mobility so they can sprint infinitely, and get right here, okay? And maybe even load it out with a grenadier or grenadier perk, which allows you to hold three grenades, or the light rifle. So you can shoot. Notice how I can now provide cover fire on all of the enemy players who are standing here trying to get the sword, trying to drop. And if I run out of grenades, I can just jump up here and grab some. The reason why you want to stay behind here is because you can see how their sight line is cut off. As soon as I get behind this, their sight line is cut off and they can't kill me. I can also stay behind cover if enemies charge and sort of duck out and shoot them. It's a very difficult angle for an enemy player to shoot you on the street. So guys, those are some of my opening map strategies for Haven. So now let's talk about some opening rush strategies for the map Adrift. Now here on Adrift, a lot of players tend to walk forward, see the sniper rifle in their low hall. This is the low hall. I call this box hall because it has, you know, little boxes in the hallway. And then you have the high hall or attic. That's just what I call them. You can call them whatever you want. And they rush through low hall and they're like, okay, so I'm going to go grab this sniper. This is a bad idea because you are at a disadvantage being the player that is on the lower level. You're on the lower level here. An enemy player rushing this sniper, which there likely will be at a higher level and can do this to you, firing you at an angle that is very hard to compensate for. They can also bounce nades very easily into this area, okay? So it's very critical that you do not charge this side of the map. Instead, let me show you some other strategies. Alright, so for opening rush strategies on the map Adrift, what you really want to be doing is rushing straight for the overshield, and here is how you do so. The fastest way to the overshield is like this. Underneath this stairway, sprinting all the way over here, cutting this corner really tight, jumping, and then thruster packing up to the overshield. This is one of the fastest ways to reach the overshield, unless you're running and sprinting and jetpacking up to the overshield. When you have a thruster pack, it's really nice because you can alter your trajectory here and then grab the overshield. I guarantee this is one of the fastest sprinting ways to get the overshield. If you can master cutting these corners in the hallways really close and then jumping up and doing this really quickly, you can grab it like no tomorrow. And then you'll be shooting enemy players running through this same hallway, and they're really easy kills. In fact, a lot of this falls like dominoes at the beginning of the map if you have two or three enemy players charge out here. Now, another type of opening strategy on Adrift is to go into the attic. This is not the fastest way to get the overshield, but it does require a person who is good at aiming. So this person wants to run up here, your pack through that little ramp, run up here and immediately look here, okay? And this person may even want to have the Grenadier perk on or a light rifle, because they're going to be wanting to put in as much fire as possible. Notice so I can back around this corner, and they can only hit me by nading this little area right here. This area is a little bit more slanted, and the grenades would bounce there if they hit that wall. But if they hit a grenade right here, it would bounce right here, like harm me. But I could just jump out of the way behind here. You just really want to be providing support on players trying to charge the overshield. Now, what your final player should be doing is going for the sniper rifle. So they need to go sprint through here, and this is best, again, best with mobility, because you can sprint infinitely, sprinting all the way through here to the sniper. And you don't really want to pick up the sniper here. You want to sprint and then jump, and you want to jump on top of these and just shoot and nade any enemy players coming through here. And as soon as you grab that sniper rifle, either run through here back to where your teammates are and start sniping enemy players over here, or you need to be lifting back to your base if you're under pressure, and then going back through here to center where your overshield carrier is, or jumping up here to your attic and going back inadvertently to the center of the map. So those are the opening strategies that I normally run for Adrift. So now let's look at some opening strategies on the map Simplex. Now right off the start here, it's really, really key to bring this to your attention that knowing where the railgun spawns is critical for opening rushes, because when you spawn on this side, it's not visually apparently obvious which side the railgun or the needler will be on. It's almost memorization. As blue team, you'll always spawn on the same side in blue base, and the railgun will always be to your left. So one of your guys, or should I say probably two of them, need to charge over to purple immediately, nade right here, right there, right, and then grab railgun in a conjunction with taking out players going for it. And this second player who's charging with this other player needs to get up here as fast as possible and throw a grenade right about here. If it was a normal grenade, it would bounce sort of over here, and it would be able to even further take out players who are hiding a little bit behind over here. And you want to grab plasmas and continue to throw them over here, and then look top center for your other teammates who will be jumping top center. And let me show you how to do this. This is actually a really cool jump that you're able to do on this map. And the opening rush, just jump over here, sprint, jump top center, crouch a little bit, and there you go. Okay, this is definitely an easily made jump, and I just want to show you guys this because it's really not that difficult. You just have to jump off the last second. You jump up here, resume sprinting, and jump right as you hit the edge of this platform, like this. And there you go. You can also jump and hit this if you want to go even over here and come through this way, and then grab the overshield. Overshield. That's a great way to surprise the enemy team. And if you even want to, after you put some shots on the enemy team, drop down and you can even grab this little scatter shot, which is not on your HUD. And just to let you guys know, your fourth player should also probably be jumping top center as well. Your fourth player could jump top center, or he could go to the yellow side of the map. But here's why I really don't recommend spreading out your forces so thin across the map. You really do want to be pairing up as teammates. You want to be two people go here, two people go there. or one person slightly diverges to grab a power weapon and then immediately comes back and gets back with their teammate. That's always how you want to work those strategies. You want to stay together as teams, especially off the beginning rushes of the game, so you can help each other out. And it's really critical that if you get naded here and aren't able to get the overshield, you back down and try to stay alive here as your teammates up high maintain their position. You only want to completely back down, obviously, if you've gotten one shot. The opening rushes on this map are much more hectic, and that's why I'm spending a little more time explaining exactly what you need to do. All right, so let's talk about some opening map strategies for Solace. Now, I'm going to be blatantly honest with you. If I were running a team, my strategy would be to make all four players charge for the fuel rod, which spawns on the side of the map. When you spawn on base side and not fourth base side, you go to the left, as I'm doing here. You can charge through this tunnel or go the one a little bit to the right and charge straight through here for the fuel rod. I would have all four of my teammates charge here. But oftentimes, teammates who are good at the sniper really want to get the sniper. And I just don't think there are as useful places to snipe on this map. Again, this is just my opinion. Maybe an expert sniper could do really well. But with this whole entire bottom floor area, I just don't think, from my experience of playing this map, especially in Team Slayer, sniping doesn't get you a whole lot of kills. It's having the ammo perk and the mobility perk, which allows you to sprint infinitely, as I talked about at the beginning of this video, and getting this fuel rod, having a buttload of ammo, 20 rounds to be exact, one of which will kill an enemy opponent, getting that fuel rod, and then bum rushing the enemy base. You'll take out any sort of sniper or sword they have as long as you have teammate support. Now, I do want to notice a second opening rush strategy on this map that you can take advantage of if you so wish to grab the sniper rifle. And that is, two players you never want to rush one player into your snipe tower. It's a bad idea because, unfortunately, a lot of enemy teams bum rush the snipe tower for the sniper rifle because it's the first thing up here is on your HUD. So they bum rush up here and you see three or four enemy players up here in their tower. But what you want to do is you want to spawn with a DMR or light rifle and you want to come up here, and this is where the stability armor mod might actually be useful. One of the few times when loading out with it might be actually a good idea, at least just for the beginning of this game, because coming up here and peeking up over this ledge, you can get a good range, much more range than the BR that I'm currently using, and shoot the enemy players across map. Wait for them to make the mistake. It's not critical for you to run out and grab the sniper rifle. You're just gonna die doing this. Hang back here, get one or two kills, and suppress the enemy team enough to where you can run out. Now, don't sprint for the sniper rifle. Never do that. Always be zooming and looking at the enemy sniper, and then pick it up and drop immediately. Or jump off the tower somehow. It's a bad idea just to stay on the tower simply because someone could easily just five shot you with the DMR from across the map. Always do that in pairs of two. Never do that as one person charging the snipe tower. It's a bad idea. And again, personally, I would just make all four people go for the fuel rod. It is that important. And I just wanted to say another thing about the opening rush strategy to this side. When you come over here, one person needs to be the designated fuel rod gun carrier. He needs to be the one going for and picking up the fuel rod. Everyone else needs to just be killing everyone who's coming towards him and just really looking over in this direction. In fact, if you ever grab the sniper rifle, you're going to want to drop down probably on the side that the fuel rod is, jumping off your sniper tower and really looking on this side to watch for players who are maybe escaping with a fuel rod you weren't able to get, or supporting your teammates as they try to get away with the fuel rod. The person grabbing the fuel rod should be able to stay alive based on your cover fire. All right, so now let's move to some opening rush strategies for the map Complex. And since this map is not the same on both sides, this is technically called asymmetrical map and not a symmetrical map, we'll be going over each side separately. Well, the opening rush strategies for red will be separate from blue, which will be starting with blue side. So blue spawns in this base. One of your teammates needs to get that sniper rifle, which just spawned on your roof. So you're gonna wanna jump up here, sprint, jump, crouch, jump. Should I say? Grab the sniper, jump over here to this ramp, and immediately peek up over here. Now there are two or three places you want to be watching. You got really good angles from up here. You want to be watching people jetpacking from their floor up here. You want to be watching this doorway because people are going to be lifting up there on the opposite side of this building. They're going to be lifting up this building and then coming out this doorway or this doorway. So that's what you're going to be want to be watching. Not much need to watch this doorway or down here because your teammates who are charging from right here, they should be having a very clear view of this doorway, as you can see. Your goal as a sniper up here is to prevent the players down here where I am right now from having to worry about enemy players who are up here, getting them one shot and finishing them off as fast as possible. So, from a normal player's perspective, someone who's not grabbing the sniper rifle will need to probably loading out with dexterity, possibly even the jetpack. This is where the jetpack can be pretty useful. Sprinting here and either jetpacking up to the rockets and grabbing them, or doing this with the thruster pack, maintaining your angle and grabbing the rockets. Now with the rockets, you're going to want to charge straight up here, reload them or whatever if you fired one, and then come around here and immediately move towards their lift house. Now let's move to red side's opening rush strategies. All right, so now let's go over red side's opening rush strategies on the map complex. So as red team, you do spawn over here, and as you may have been guessed from the first part of this complex tutorial on opening rush strategies, the red team does have a much harder time getting to the rocket launcher, as there are only two or three main points of entry. You have people who can jetpack from the floor up here. What I'd actually recommend doing is jumping more up here onto this roof. And then you have the lift that will lift you into the building. And then you have, obviously, the rush to this doorway and then a straight run to the rockets while fighting every enemy player in known existence. So let me show you some opening rush strategies for this. One of your teammates absolutely needs to grab the sniper. This is most easily done by just simply running through this doorway, running around here, and running straight up and grabbing the sniper. Now, it is pivotal that the sniper on red side get into position very quickly, because the enemy sniper is going to have a much easier time of getting into his position. So it is critical that the enemy sniper not be completely obvious, and this is why I recommend the enemy your sniper get jetpacked, so we can come over here and jetpack up to this area. And from there, he should be able to get a really nice vantage point on the enemy sniper without obviously jumping over to here like I just did. That's exactly what the enemy sniper is going to be looking for. You want to try to jetpack up here and then look out and peek over and snipe the enemy sniper, or he may still be hiding back there where their sniper spawns. Now, for as far as normal players are concerned in this gameplay, let's go ahead and talk over what they do. So, I would say definitely two players need to rush up this lift, okay? One of them obviously needs to go into the right side here. One of them needs to go into the left side here. So, the first player needs to go here and obviously peek out here. Now, it is pivotal that he look out and then call to his teammates what he sees. Not necessarily just straight sprinting for the rockets, because he is not in a position to easily do so. He might be able to sprint and jump, but this means he's going to be in a straight line with everyone shooting him from this doorway and there. It's going to be a pretty easy kill for the enemy team. This guy over here on the right should be making a run for rockets. Okay, he should be running over here, jumping to this platform, grabbing rockets, and immediately when you grab rockets, thrust the pack off and try to get away through this tunnel, or if you don't see any enemy players in your radar, again, jumping up here and right there. Now, I didn't talk about the fourth player, so let me go ahead and discuss that for a brief moment. While that one guy is maintaining his position, this fourth player needs to have charged out of your base, okay, and around here. He needs to charge out of the base and around here to this doorway, okay? And he needs to be firing as much as humanly possible at the enemy team. putting nades right here and right here for people who will be jetpacking or trying to thruster pack up to this map. This guy's nades are critical because he has the most open position of this side, and his other teammates really don't have access to this angle. So his job, literally, is to put himself in a position where he can immediately shoot people who grab rockets. And what I'd like this player to do normally is, instead of stay here, which is what a lot of players end up doing, let your teammates do the work. If your teammates have perfectly executed their pushes, okay, then you should be able to stop running here, peek out, shoot, and move over to this side. This allows you to shoot anyone who grabs the rockets. Notice how I told the enemy strategy of grabbing rockets and immediately dropping off here. Well, the guy standing over here now has an angle and can kill that guy. This guy who just grabbed rockets on the enemy team is likely to be one shot as he's dropping down or running away or reloading. And so if you rotate over to this side, you should be able to shoot, kill him. That's just my strategy for grabbing the rockets. And I know if someone were to come over here and do that to me, that would be very annoying. And it would most likely kill me. So guys, those are the opening rush strategies for Complex. They were a little complex, weren't they? So here are some opening rush strategies for the map Dispatch. This is a remake of the map Relay, which is on the disc, but the version called Dispatch is in matchmaking. So here you have me spawning as blue team, and this is how you really want to get the overshield, which spawns top center. You want to rush forward like this as fast as possible, jump and thruster pack towards the overshield. Now, I didn't do it perfectly there, but optimally you'd be wanting to have a second person do the exact same thing, except from the left side. Charging right here, and then thruster packing, grabbing overshield. Now, what the next person should do is they should be flanking by either going to the right or to the left. I'd like to say that the third person should be going over like this and shooting top center as well as their plat, and then jumping up onto yellow and then providing shots right here. Another optional strategy for this third player is to jump onto this beam. Jump onto this beam right here by crouch jumping, and it's a little bit difficult, but you can jump up here. I don't know why I failed that so many times, but with some practice, you can get up here and you can shoot their sniper. Oftentimes their sniper, while he may be anticipating this jump, I know a lot of pro players are, most normal players are not anticipating you to jump to ring three like this, and it can surprise their sniper very, very easily. Now this does require crouch jumping, crouching at the very top of your jump, obviously, so that's how you get up there. Now, as far as your fourth player needs to be obviously jumping over here, maybe even jumping through this window, which it is very, very possible to, grabbing the sniper, and then looking across at their sniper, possibly even sniping or trying to snipe the person who has overshield. This is, you really want to send your best snipers over here, because split-second timing on people appearing while they're sprinting and just being there for half a second and nailing that headshot is really, really hard to do, and while battling an enemy sniper who also has a sniper on the opposite side of the map is really difficult. So that's definitely, send your best snipers that way. So those are the opening rush strategies for Dispatch. All right, so now let's talk about some opening strategies on the Forge map Scythe. This is on the Forge world of Impact. You want to know where this map was created, obviously the asteroids and everything. This is where blue team spawns, and as you can see, the only power weapon of notice here is the sniper rifle. And the quickest way to get to the sniper rifle is just to jump across to this platform and jump over here. Now, you don't want to be jumping out to the open because the enemy team is going to literally walk up this ramp and do the exact same thing. In fact, the enemy team, that's literally the only place they're going to be, is on this ramp trying to get to the sniper rifle. Now, of course, there are other methodologies of getting around. I'd say one of the things that you want to start out doing on this map as blue team is you want to send at least one guy over here, and so he can drop down and shoot players trying to get into sniper. He also may nade right there and get a really good nade in there if enemy players try to go for the sniper rifle. As far as enemy players charging for the sniper rifle, you want to have one player who's really good at long-range combat load out with a light rifle and come and look right here and crouch up and down and just get really good long-range shots into here across the map. That really will be cleaned up by enemy players. And then, of course, you want to have two players running and using this platform to get over here on this area. You might send one bottom or one around through here, but that really depends on your strategy. There's a lot of ways to approach getting this sniper rifle. From the opposite side, it is obviously much more difficult to get the sniper. You're going to be spawning somewhere over here. I know I'm blue team, but I'll just quickly show you because the strategies are very similar. You may want to send someone through the bottom over here to try to end up shooting people who come around. But with this strategy, the main goal for red team is not to necessarily flank around, because that's much harder to do. The main strategy is to pick up the sniper rifle as fast as humanly possible and jetpack thruster pack back with it so that they can get back into the game and just get away with the sniper rifle. It's not necessarily about baiting the enemy team or curving around the map as much as blue team spawns. Red team, you got to be insanely aggressive and have really good nades. Having a nade like right here, so that it bounces just to the side of the doorway, would be a great nade. You don't want to spawn right here and start chunking your nades at the doorway. This is completely pointless to do so. And here's the reason why. Because the enemy team just spawned, they're not going to be in the doorway where your grenades are going. They're going to be standing about as far as you are from the doorway, and they're going to be sprinting for it. So you only want to start actually throwing nades once you are close to the doorway, once you are actually kind of close, or you think they will be kind of close. For example, if I was right here, I'd say now is the time to throw a nade. I'd toss a nade right here at the floor, and it'd pop right here and explode here. So that way, any enemy players who are jumping over here would be naded by that. So just keep that in mind when you're throwing nades off your spawn at the beginning of the game. You only want to throw them when the enemy players are actually getting close to the same location you are getting close to. All right, so now let's talk about some starting strategies on the map Abandoned. Now, I'm going to be blatantly honest, this is not my favorite map to play in Team Slayer, simply because blue team spawns on the lower end of the map, lower beach, lower roots, as you can see the roots here, or lower boxes. And while we still do to get a sniper rifle like the enemy team does, it is not as easy for us because we are on the lower side, meaning headshots are easier for the enemy team once they push top middle. And also, to top everything off, it is a little bit harder, a few steps longer, that is, to be exact, to reach the overshield with spawns bottom center in front of the lift. So let me show you the fastest way from blue side to get to the overshield. It is not what I'm doing right now, rushing around the outside to here. That is the wrong way, and that is not the fastest way at all. This is the fastest way. You want to run around here, hug the wall as much as possible. Sorry, I stopped sprinting there. And then you grab the overshield. If you feel yourself getting pressured, immediately lift top center. You probably should do that anyway. I would not engage a whole lot of people alone down here. And the reason why is because your teammates, if they follow my opening strategy, they won't be down there to help you. You want to lift top center with that overshield as fast as possible to get away from people and get top control. Your other two teammates, the ones who are not going after the sniper rifle, which I'll show in just a second, should be one running on the left side right here and one running up the right side right here. And they don't want to drop here. That is incorrect. They want to just provide support fire for their teammate going after the overshield. And if he dies, or even if he doesn't die, they want to immediately, after that skirmish takes place, they want to immediately push up. And if enemy players go up this little lift up here and come out right here, what they want to do is they want to sit right here and throw a grenade. And this is really good at weakening players, or because oftentimes when players, when a player comes out of the lift, they turn and start going around. And so that can really take advantage of someone, especially if the enemy player grabbed the overshield and then got top middle, which is a very unfortunate position. That's why it's so unfortunate, this map, is because if you're red team, you can just, you have a few steps, a head start, you can grab the overshield, go up the lift, and you immediately have top center control, which is what you want on this map. You do not want to be on beach spawn at all. You want to be on top and in this back area. Now, as far as grabbing the sniper, the fourth guy is going to run over here and immediately grab that off the start of the map. And you may be a little bit surprised by this, but the sniper wants to sprint over here just like this. And he wants to be looking top center, okay? And he also, to cover his teammates, because by the time he makes it over here, the overshield skirmish has already begun and may have even ended. And so people may even already be lifting to top center. So he needs to really be supportive of his teammates and push up using this tree, and this tree as cover, okay? And if he can recognize that in a lot of enemy players have died from the initial engagement and a lot of teammates have survived, he needs to immediately push up around here and make it somehow to top middle. The goal of this map, really, if I may speak briefly for a moment, is to get the enemy team to start spawning on beach, which means you do have to have one guy sort of back in the back here, but the rest of your three teammates can be sort of top middle, and this is where sniper really begins to shine, to pick off people spawning in the beach. This is the optimal sort of place to be on this map. So let's switch to red team strategy on this map. So as you can see by the place where red team spawns on the bottom of this map here, they do have an extreme advantage to getting to the overshield. All they have to do is run through this doorway here and grab the overshield. And you can even tell in the video how easy and quick that is for them to get the overshield. Now, of course, one of the enemy players does want to lift up and grab the sniper, and there's many ways that they can approach this situation. I personally, with a sniper, would immediately push up right here, and I would sometimes even holster my sniper and start tossing nades at this bridge, trying to prevent people from doing this. And the second thing I would do is I would drop right here and begin sniping people who are trying to get up to top center. This is a really good place to snipe, and it's also a good way to watch for the enemy sniper and see where he's coming. Obviously, if you were following my strategies, he'd be over here by now. But you get a head start. You can grab the sniper and be over here almost before the enemy sniper has a chance to set up. It's much easier if red team executes their strategy quickly. It's much easier for them to set up very quickly. I would definitely suggest that a second player sprint for the overshield as well. And here's the reason why. Because there is a lift here, even if that second player who doesn't have the overshield gets naded somehow, he can immediately go through the lift to top center. And that's a real critical reason to do so. The fourth and final player should be with the sniper guy who just went up this lift, grabbed the sniper, and went top center, as I said. And he should also be nading. He should also be jumping up here on the sort of left side here and nading this area. And you can go over this sort of with your team. Do you want the sniper guy who has a sniper to go to the left? And do you want the guy with the ER? Do you want him to go around to the right over here and throw grenades from this angle? It all depends on what you're doing and how you're doing it. You could have a guy who's loading out three grenades and the grenadier perk. You could get him to come over here and throw three grenades at the beginning of the game. It all depends on how you want to do it, but you do want to get that overshield guy top center and immediately begin picking off enemy players. The worst thing that could possibly happen is for you all to die, and then the enemy team is pushed up all the way to top center and you start spawning on the beach. You as red team have the advantage. So I don't really much say this on many other maps, but hanging back here in this area is actually not too bad of an idea, simply because you will spawn your teammates back here if they die up there. So it's not too bad of an idea, but you can see there's not many angles to shoot the enemy players here, you know, on the map. So charge forward, but be a little cautious. You know, you don't want to charge over here and stand right here. This is just a terrible idea. You want to really be passive aggressive and use these sort of flanks to your advantage, where you can come around here and shoot. Red team does definitely have the advantage. Another thing that people sometimes don't know is that this is called Magic Tree, because it has a lift up that takes you over here. Just another reason why this side of the map is better than the other side, because there's so much more maneuverability. This box as well will allow you to jump to top center, and it just really, I mean, it really makes this side of the map so much better than deep side. So sorry I spent so much time on that map. Let's move to the next map. All right, so let's now look out some starting strats on the map Shutout. Now this is an asymmetrical map, as you can see, and so I will be showing you from both sides of this arena. But you can see the sword spawns directly below here, so you're going to want to send one of your teammates down to get that sword. Now, what I would like to say is that I have not played very many Team Slayer games on this map, so my overall tips will be more geared towards a few of the players on your team, what they definitely should be doing. But as far as for the rest of your team, I'm not exactly sure where everyone should be going on your team on this map. But I do know this. Red team, since they spawn up here, have a really pivotal advantage, because you want to send a lot of your teammates up here, and here's the reason why. Blue team spawns down there. They're kind of at a mild disadvantage. They spawn down there on elbow. Because you as red team, because you spawn in this building, you can run, come over here, run, jump like this, and nade, where they're going to obviously be charging up. You see, so as blue team, and I'm actually not going to switch to blue team, I'm just going to show you from over here, blue team spawns right here. So what they're going to obviously be doing is running around and up here, up this ramp. So as red team, what you want to be doing is you want to be charging out around here, jump onto this, jump and throw a nade as soon as you can. You can also use this little platform up here to sort of ambush them as well. But you really want to take control of this sniper as red team. You have that advantage. And another advantage that red team does slightly have on this map is dropping for the sword. You want to send one of your guys bottom, drop, grab sword, run. And the reason why you're sprinting for this is because one of the blue guys is going to probably go for the shotgun, which spawns underneath here. So what you want to do is you want to sprint out of, grab the sword, sprint out of here, sprint around the corner, and try to kill the guy who's charging from blue side all the way over here to try to get to the shotgun. And that's generally what you want to be trying to do as red team. Now, as blue team, it's a little bit more challenging and difficult, but here's one main strategy that I have been able to identify. As red team, it is obviously the wrong idea, as I just showed you, ties in nicely, to charge all your teammates up this ramp at the same time. You do want to have one or two people charge and want to try to push up to this area, of course, because you have to grab the sniper rifle somehow, right? But you also want a teammate who comes right here and jumps like this, completely avoiding all the naves going over here. You want him to jump right here because you want him to come around and be able to flank whoever is going after the sniper by using this and this platform right here. It's really critical that you get top control by using these jumps and just avoiding enemy grenades in general. So those tips weren't as detailed as some of the other maps, but I hope those helped you out. And this does conclude the Team Slayer starting strats video. I hope you guys like it, and do share it with your friends, like, favorite, you know, the business. And I'll see you in the next capture or whatever I end up recording. Peace, guys.